sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know when it's here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah, I tried to show him. Yeah, 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 yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger flame, he in sicko mode.
Made this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they get me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys, that's Nike boys hopping our coupes. Way too big when we pull up, give me the loot.
Give me the loot.
Was off the Remy, had up at Post. Had to hit my old town to duck the news. 2-4 hour lockdown, we made no moves. Now it's 4 a.m. and I'm back up popping with the crew. I just landed in, Chase B mixes pop like Jamba Juice. Different color chains, think my jeweler really selling fruits. And they joking, man, know the crackers wish it was the news.
Someone said,
surrender retreat, we all in too deep. Play for keeps, don't play us a week.
Someone said,
surrender retreat, we all in too deep.
Way too formal, y'all know I don't follow suit. Stacy Dash, most of these girls ain't got a clue. All of these old, I made off records I produce. I might take all my exes and put them all in a group. Hit my essays, I need the booch. About to turn this function into Bonnaroo. Told her I been, you coming too. In the 305, treat me like I'm Uncle Luke. Lock the top off, it's just a roof. She said, where we going? And I set the moon. We ain't even make it to the room. She thought it was the ocean, it's just a pool. Now I gotta open, it's just a ghost. Who put this shit together? I'm the glue.
I'm the glue.
Said,
shorty face, Tommy out the blue.
Lake Effect radio station, we dripping over here.
Someone said,
a young interview.
Someone said,
put some talent on the spot. Put some talent on the spotlight. Hopefully y'all enjoying the show. Yes, Travis Scott. Hey, but you know what? After this Travis Scott, I'm about to play this Meek Mill. So.
Tell me how you want it.
Without you for 7 days straight, and now I can't live without you. And if we ever broke up, I won't have a kid without you. You forever in my heart. I won't forget about you. I be crushing you on Monday like it's Wednesday. You press about that with your friends say. G63 is with your right. Ben say. I'm so happy you ain't listen to your friends, babe. You can tell me how you want it, how you need it. I don't mind. She's right about my side, cause I decided it's out of mind. And I despite you hit the climb, but I was hype. I hit your line a few more times. When you hit back, I'm gonna respond.
Got Young Ty. Hey, can y'all give us a small introduction into what Ion Records is real quick? Starting with you, Ty, cause you're closest to me.
So, Ion Records is a music label that doesn't judge. It's like a family. We work together to build you up. Try to build a platform for you, network you across the United States. We take different artists and push them at a different level. We have artist development programs as well to help you develop your skill in the work you want to become, develop your craft.
So he a craft developer over here. And then to the right of you, you got 4-4 Prodigy. So let us know where you from, Prodigy, and what's
up? I'm from Beulah. That's where the 440 come from.
Okay, you from the Beulah. Where at in the Beulah?
On the east side right now. But I've been all over actually, Beulah for real. 43rd, Bonnywood.
He said all over.
The Harbor. The Harbor,
moving
baby,
and grooving.
For a minute. Yeah.
What's the projects out there called?
I mean, we got State. 43rd, Bonnywood, Woodman.
All grimy.
Yeah.
He said it's all cutthroat out there. So what brought you from a spot like Asher Bueller to want to do music? Like, how long have you been doing music?
I've been doing music for like a few years and shit now. And stuff now, sorry. And I don't know, I just love doing music for real. I would do music if I didn't make money. Like, obviously I want to make money on music, but even if I didn't make money, I would still do music. You feel me? I just love doing music.
It's what's in your heart.
Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot.
So where did you grow up originally? You from originally from Beulah?
I'm from Beulah, yeah.
Yeah, and what is a typical day like that, like out there for a young man?
So, in Beulah, for me?
Yeah, for you. For
I'm way more calm now. I work at a pizza joint. That's a good time for me. I'm way more settled down now. I'm a different person than I used to be. I used to do dumb stuff with less reputable people, but.
But what made that dynamic change? That shift that caused you to go from making?
I got robbed myself. Okay. When you feel that, like when you get something taken from you that you work hard for and everything, like you feel how like people feel when you do that to them, and it's like. I can't do that no more.
Right. He said he got tired of that karma.
I can't do it. I'm a good person, so, though.
Where is the fourfold prodigy? Where does that come in at? Where did you receive that name at?
I gave it to myself, for real. Because, all right, so, like, I'm from 440. That's the 440 part. And then it's a broken heart because, like, I lost a lot of people in Beulah, for real, from, like, drug use and stuff like that. So... And then the prodigy is just because I'm like self-taught. I mean, I started rapping because of my big bro and stuff, and my other friend, like Fredman and stuff like that. But like, I started doing my my own thing and everything. But like, yeah, the prodigy is just because like I don't write anything down, man. Everything's off my head. I don't write anything down, and I taught myself. You know what I'm saying? I was really bad at first. I'd be freestyling, it would just be straight awful, and I feel like I come a long way. You know what I'm saying? Definitely come a long way.
He said he came a long way. So how did you end up linking up with Ion Records, and what was the motivation?
Oh, just an opportunity, man. I mean, I hit him up. I sent him a few of my songs, and I sent a bunch of labels my songs, and he hit me back, and we sat down and we talked, and I just like everything that he was coming with, and like the plans that he has right now. Like, people don't know like where we from it right now, and like we ain't really about to talk on it right now, right, too much, but like we got big things coming, you know what I'm saying? And like,
absolutely.
I just can't wait for it, you know what I'm saying?
Said
it's just an opportunity for me, you know what I'm saying? I just gotta make something of the opportunity, which yeah. I will, you know what I'm saying? I promise.
Yeah, you will. You up here, you're doing a lot more than what most people doing with their careers. Sitting online waiting for Instagram to pump them up. You know, you coming up here, taking the initiative.
Yeah.
So, Ty, I wanted to ask you real quick, like, where you from and how did you get everything started? What was your motivation?
Well, I'm originally from Cleveland, Ohio, and I moved out to Asher Bueller for Lord knows why.
Right.
I did, and I regretted it, but I'm here now, and I can't seem to get out yet. So back in the day, I used to do music hardcore. I used to do pop music. I blew up off a song called Be My Girlfriend, and it showed me a whole another level of music and opportunity that I could do. And I started reaching out and talking to people, and, you know, they wanted to craft my skill, but they were charging the arm and the leg and wanted, you know, money that, you know, a regular label or someone that wants to invest in you shouldn't do. So I'm like, all right, I went to college, the Berklee College of Music, for a music business, and I learned the ins and outs of the business.
Yeah.
Because that's the first step. You have to know the business as well, not just about music. You have to know the business.
Right.
Both sides. So I did that, and now I attend Full Sail University for music production and engineering.
Had to.
To hit all aspects of the industry.
Yeah.
So I created this label, Ion. It means it's all or nothing. So you always want to give your all, and you ain't going to start trying.
How you spell it?
It's I-A-O-N.
I was about to say, I knew it was some type of different type of spelling involved.
Yeah, so it means it's all or nothing. So if you don't give your all, then why try?
Right.
You know, and I wanted to give to artists opportunities that I had my hands on to be able to push these artists and develop these artists and show their talent instead of just sitting behind a screen and pushing a song to share and then boom, another song, share. Because right. it's more about than just sharing. You have to be out there. You have to be in the field. You have to represent yourself as well as have other people promote you and push you and network for you while you're at home doing what you got to do.
Right.
Sell tickets.
Yeah, sell tickets. Hey, man, you know, everything that you said, it sound like pretty much the ingredients for a successful venture in life, man. What type of influences did you take, and what kind of music are you looking for as far as from artists? What type of sound do you want your record company to specifically display to America, to the world?
Well, it's all genres. So I have people submitting music from country, pop, indie, trap, rap, punk rock. I mean, they're all over. As long as you have talent and you're willing to put in the effort to succeed and do what you have to do to succeed, then I'm willing to work with you.
Huh, he said he ready to work.
Exactly, I'm ready to put in this work. I spend days where I sleep for an hour, do my at-home dad
sound
duties.
Like me.
And other than that, I'm on the computer, I'm networking, I'm grinding, I'm doing what I gotta do, I'm reaching out to people.
Yeah.
I send out, thousands of emails every single day to a bunch of people, to DJs, to television, to radio, to be able to connect these artists to the outside world where they need to be to succeed. I mean, I've learned from a bunch of industry level where I've connected with them. I've spoken with Sony Def Jams. I have them as a distribution connection now. I've worked with people in Def Jam where I have them as an A&R kind of situation where they can review my artists and tell me what they need worked on, things like that.
Right.
So they're not only getting it from a local perspective and just another ear, they're also getting their information and their advice from the labels.
Hey, and you know what? That's the best thing, because I think in an era where they're getting away from like CD sales and all that, if you ain't booming, like have some type of presence or like something that's gonna make them some money, they really don't care, because
exactly,
they want you to pay them.
Exactly. When you sign with a major label, it's all about, they'll give you that check in the beginning, but that's just saying, all right, this is what you got to do with it. If you spend that money on something else, or you don't make those sales to get that money back, you owe them that money.
Nah, you owe.
So you're in a worse predicament than when you started.
Right.
you got to owe them. That's your life right there. You signed away.
Yeah, it is. So as an owner and knowing that information, as a record label owner and knowing that information, how are you going to avoid those type of structures for your artists? And how are you going to make sure that your artist's music is promoted to the world and that they do become successful?
Well, what I do is, since I don't want to charge anybody, because I charge nobody for anything that they do right now. We're again, just building up, starting up, so from the ground up. But the people that I've networked with in school, and just by talking and showing an interest, not in getting signed, but on the inside and the business side of it, I'm able to work with these higher industry levels for free, to where they can work with me to build me up as well,
right,
as a CEO of a record label, as an A&R of a record label, as an artist manager, as a person to develop these artists. So they teach me everything that I need to know for free. So I'm gonna give my services away as well for free. Now, if there's an artist that's not signed to my label, of course I gotta charge, because that's they're not underneath me.
Right.
So I still have to make a living somehow, So when these artists come, hey, can you submit my music to Sony, or can you see what he says if I need feedback?
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's gonna cost you. You want an email blast of 1,000 or 2,000, 3,000 DJs?
Huh.
Yeah, it's gonna cost, because it doesn't. Well, yeah. It takes time.
Yeah, that was my next question. Not to cut you off, how do you make money as a record label? If you offer your services and you're not, charging anybody nothing, what is it like? What do you think are some incremental, some things that are going to be very important for you to be able to sustain a lifestyle as an independent record artist in Ohio?
Well, yeah, Ohio's dead. So what I do, I actually do work side jobs as well. I'm about to be starting again at Lincoln Electric. So just like an artist has to invest in themselves, I'm investing in my label so that my label can grow, and I'm growing an investment, putting my money in a fund and letting it grow so that way I can give more to my artists.
Right.
Right now, the people that I'm working with, thankfully, do these services for free and help me build up. And especially while I'm in school, I get these loans out too, and I start a business, a credit with my business.
Yeah.
As well as a loan, but I do pay off my own debt or my own loans.
You said you master, man. You sure you from Cleveland?
Yes.
And you smart like that, man.
Yes, I hit the books. When people were out judging me, making fun of me, I'm hitting the books.
They were like, you
so
a little nerd,
a
huh?
Yeah.
Look at that nerd, man. He over there reading books. He finna go get high and drunk.
Exactly. I was
where
out
they
there.
At jail
already.
Now, huh?
Yeah, most of them that I hung with, yeah, are in trouble. I hit the books as far as like researched, networking, researched venues, research things that you need to know on the inside of the business, as well as researching by talking to these people.
Right.
And reaching out saying, hey, you have a second to talk. I grew up with family, luckily, in the industry already. down the line that are already, you know, up there and big.
Yeah.
And I've learned from them too. I don't want to just give them my music and say, hey, put me famous, you know, hey, make me famous, put me out there.
Right.
No, I'm gonna do it myself. I'm gonna build myself up and build these artists up so that we're not cheating our way into the system.
Yes. Hey. Nice. Hey. Hey. Hey.
We up here with Ion Records and 440 Prodigy doing a nice little interview, man. You know, and I think that a lot of what they're saying really is just about opportunity, power, and motivation, you know, meeting up. So how did you guys meet? I forgot. I don't know if I asked that question yet or not.
I sent him a few of my songs. And then he
You said you were submitting music to different labels? How did that work out for you?
I just said F it, and I was just sending my music to like a bunch of different labels like I knew it would never even pay attention to me, right? But I was just sending it to them just cause. And then the ones that cost money to submit something, I didn't.
So what kind of style do you feel like you offer the hip hop world?
So like, for me, I do like everything, but right now I'm on my like wavy stuff. I'm on my like my sing songy stuff. I'm liking that a lot right now.
So what would that be? What, Post Malone?
No, I ain't got a voice that good. But
I mean that's auto tune.
I put a little bit of auto tune on my stuff. Yeah, not too much though. But like,
as an artist, I feel like you should be able to do what you want to do. You know what I mean? I mean, if that's okay with your label owner.
Exactly.
You know, if somebody feel like auto tune gonna help improve their quality of what type of music they make, then yeah, so be it.
I don't think I sound bad without it. You know what I'm saying? I just think it sounds fire with it sometimes.
Right. Ain't nothing wrong with that at all. So tell me this: when was the first age that you first got inspired by music, and what music was it? Both of you guys.
Also, like when I first started rapping, I was into like snap rap. I was into Slaughterhouse, Eminem, like Shady 2.0, Cypher. That was big for me. Hobson was coming up at that time.
Strange Music.
Yeah. Worldwide Choppers, the song Worldwide Choppers, just stuff like that. Now I'm into like everything now, man. I like Token. He's a snap rapper now. And then I like Caskey. You know what I'm saying? I like DaBaby. You know what I'm saying? I think you could do so much with rap. Like, I think there's so many like subgenres you can do for rap. It's crazy.
Yeah,
and I think people are doing a heck of a job at it.
They're doing good being different, huh?
Yeah.
It's not like a beef type of environment where people like back in the day with Tupac and Biggie or nothing. Ain't nobody beefing over no coast. Like, everybody really just enjoying life.
Oh, yeah. We just chilling. I'm just making music.
He said that's it.
Anybody that's in my city that's making music, I got hella love for all y'all.
Like, so who is some people that's in your city making music, that's making noise out there? Who's some people out there that's ringing bells?
I think, like, for me, for me, it's, like, my homies. I think Freddie is underrated. I think there's Freddie Three Shoes. I think he's underrated. Biscuit, that's another one. Majin Bloody, that's what he calls himself. He's fire. And I think a lot of the young ones right now, his name's Cash. He's calling himself Cash. He's fire. Like, he's actually fire, and he's young.
Ready.
He's young. And then they got like friends in that group that rap too. And then you gotta love Gunna Gang. We got Gunna Gang around Beulah right now. And I love Gunna Gang. I think what they like, they're hype, man. They're hype.
When
you see them, yeah, when you see them perform, it's crazy. And then like big bro Nico, you gotta love Nico. You know what I'm saying? You gotta respect what Nico is doing. And that's just a few, man. There's so many in Beulah.
So like, Beulah got the talent out there.
Yeah, people sleep on Beulah for real. We're talented.
What do you think is the core like, you know, where do you think that comes from? You know, the influence of music and what type of music, and like what, well, let me rewind that. What type of community is Asher Beulah? Because somebody that's not from out there.
Hold on, one more sec. Hey, Deontay Cooper, too. That man has been doing his thing for a minute, for sure. And yeah, you got to show him love. Got to. Yeah, my first couple songs were engineered by that man. Yeah. And Jay Hutz on the engineer side. And Baby Hutz, that's his little brother. He makes beats and stuff, man. They're fire, fire.
Out there working out there in Asher Beulah. So they the ones that's helping keeping the scene alive out there for artists. So they like set legacies for other people to fill shoes. What do you feel?
Yeah, and it's also different. It's crazy. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, Cash, like I said, that man, like, he's like trap. and it's fire. Like, and then Gunna Gang also like trap, and then just Majin Bloody, he's trap too, but he yell at you a little bit, you know what I'm saying? He'll scream at you a little bit. It's not like
get on his
and then Freddy
Bone, like, Crusher.
Freddy is crazy. Like, he could just switch up the flow whenever he wants to, do whatever he wants. And then my big bro is a fire rapper too. He lives in North Carolina right now, so I wouldn't even want to mention him, but my brother, yeah, my big brother's is fire.
Going in.
Fire, yeah. So my big brother Ben, you know what I'm saying? So fire.
So how was it growing up for you in Ashtabula? Like, were you rich out there? Were you poor?
No,
like,
I wasn't rich. I was definitely not poor. I was not rich though. All right, so it was like my dad was like in the picture, but not that much. I have a really good friendship with my dad now. You know what I'm saying?
Amen to that.
But when I was like 9 or 10, then we started going over to my dad's a lot, and I got like closer to him and everything. But yeah. My mom did most, man. My mom's a queen.
Yeah,
I was a queen. And my stepdad, who stepped in when I was like,
y'all.
I was in like third, or like fourth or fifth grade or something like that. And my stepdad, Jimmy Hodges, he stepped in. So, but my mom, for sure, my mom's a queen.
He said number one, mom. Yeah, my mom. All you
my mom did everything.
There.
My mom had me fresh, even when it wasn't even possible to make me fresh with the money that like we had at the time sometimes.
So has she ever discouraged you from like pursuing your music dreams, or how's your mother as far as like
at first? So like I was going to college for criminal justice, and so yeah, at first it was like a surprise to her, but she's always loved my music and everything. It's got so much better over time, and I think she's with it now. I think she believed now. She told me she believed now, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, yeah, we there.
So Ty, back to the question that I had asked him.
Which one?
Well, the very first one, where I was basically asking him about what does he feel like he bring in to the game. I asked you like what genres or whatever, but what's separating you from, you know, all these other record labels that's out there? What's gonna make somebody say, hey, you know what, Ion Records, I'm with that movement, I like what they doing, and I wanna be a part of that?
I feel like the fact that I'm actually taking action. A lot of people, they'll say they have a label. They'll say that they're gonna do this, they're gonna do that, but I never see any movement. I just see talk, hear talk, you know. It's all about actually getting out there and doing what you're saying you're gonna do. So, and being consistent as well, staying motivated.
He's had constant plans. Like, yeah. since I signed with them and everything, like, we've had constant plans. We've been doing stuff, you know what I mean? And it, like, that's dope, because sometimes I get lazy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Keep motivated.
Yeah, so to have somebody to be like, all right, we got to do this.
Right.
You have time to do this? And a lot of times I don't. I'm at work a lot. I only have like 2 days off a week, but I make it happen.
So both of y'all working 9-to-5s and grinding.
Yeah, I'm a manager. I used to be the GM out in Conneaut, Ohio. Hey. And then I moved to South Carolina for a little bit. I came back. Now I'm a manager.
Oh, you just all around.
Make decent money for real.
City country.
Making pizzas. Oh, no, I'm not front. No. I didn't live in Conneaut. I lived in Beulah still. I just drove to Conneaut to be the GM.
Oh, I was about to say, Conneaut, I've been out there. But I had to play a football game against them. We were like, oh, Lord, we out in the sticks.
The football field is...
Man, they got a Friday Night Lights football field. Them folks have spent so much
money. I love y'all, Conneaut.
So, before we get too far away from this music, and we talk about these demographics, I wanted to kind of link that up too. What, with the music industry changing up and the color of everything changing, you know what I mean? Like, they're saying we're basically going to be like one mixed population. And we got a beautiful Hispanic population that's growing. And Donald Trump is trying to put, you know, kill that off. But at the end of the day, like, do you think how important as a label art owner and as an artist do you guys think it is to reach out to the Hispanic communities?
Well, I'm part Puerto Rican. I'm Puerto Rican, Dominican, and Black. So I know it's important, and I do reach out to bilingual artists. I've reached out to Hispanic artists. I actually am working with a couple. We're hitting some remixes and some tracks where we're talking, you know, different languages. We're having Spanish as well as just English. We're having German. Different nationalities are all coming together, and I'm actually trying to work on and build a cipher with different international, you know, different nationalities.
Swear.
International, national.
Who gonna translate?
I'ma Google
who cares?
It. I'ma Google it.
Yeah, who cares? It's gonna sound fire. You ever heard rapping in a different language?
And it sounds beautiful.
It's fire. Exactly. I would do the Spanish music. I can't trill the R, so I can't do it.
They'll
eat me alive. I can't do it.
So you with the movement, basically, is what
you're
saying.
Yeah, I'm with it 100%. I can't do the music myself.
How big is the population and where you from in Ashtabula?
You talking about Hispanic?
Yeah.
A lot of Hispanics where I'm from.
Puerto Rican, Mexican, everything.
Yeah, we got a lot. We got a solid diversity where I'm from.
So Ashtabula is like pretty much like Painesville, the rest of like.
No, we small, but like, yeah.
He said we small, but it's a lot of mega. It's a melting pot.
It's a melting pot, but it's small. It's not that big.
How do you guys like get people that's where you know basically from where you're from to listen to the music that you present? Like,
I've been with most of the people in Beulah since the Sandbox. Feel me? So like since we were little kids, so my music is like even if they didn't like it, they would still listen to it just because they like who I am. They mess with me. They like me. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And the same for their music. I do the same. I listen to all their music. You know what I'm saying? So.
What kind of beat you like chopping on? I'm going to give you a beat if it's all right. We're tied and then let
you
flex.
Type in, you're not going to like this beat, but it's okay.
It's all right.
I'm going to kill it. Type in the Cuda instrumental. The 6ix9ine Cuda instrumental.
I got you. Hey, got Ashtabula in the building and the 216. 440 Prodigy, Ion Records.
Yeah.
They come to represent their label, spread this positivity through music.
We about to make it happen.
And put their city on the map.
It's the second one.
Yeah,
my fault. It's a little weird. It's a little different. Yeah.
All right, here we go.
A bit?
Yes, I can.
All right, man. Yeah.
Okay.
Look, I'm from that 440. Everybody wild out, not me though. I be chilling, I don't pull the strap out. Unless you talking on my family, the gonna be your mouth. She hopped on my stick before I even pull the cash out. I don't mess with no old O's or no new O's. I'm about to check. Mess a bad hoe, mess a sad hoe, mess a that suck the big toe. She a bimbo, throw it back, rest she been up. Pass it to my bro, 440 block, y'all ain't see it coming. I've been chilling with my goonies since a youngin.
Yeah.
Playing backyard football with the roughnecks. Now I mess with pretty girls who only like rough sex. Tell them, baby, we can, just don't ask me what's next. I cannot commit cause your entire world is suspect. That be a stadium, you'll find me past the horizon. You see me peacefully smoking the blunt in the belt of Orion. Now watch me boot the glass ceiling. Here's Johnny, I'm shining. I went from this dude, that dude, I'm Jekyll and hiding. Come from money, I trust not a soul, I got it in writing. I come off the damn dome, yeah, why would I write it? You ain't got it sitting under the tree just to become enlightened. To know that you should be immortal when you clash with a titan. Yeah, hold on, I got more.
Yeah, go.
Look, yeah. I'm on my do my own ish. Don't care if I live. My soul died a long time ago, so really it ain't ish. 440 block, this is really where I live. Where we hustle every single month just to make the rent. Where they pass out drugs like candy and you watch it kill your friends. Even people you done grown up and graduated with. Watching drugs eat up their body and it really make you sick. I'm just saying out in Beulah, this is really how it is. Doesn't matter if you're 24 or even if you're 6. If you got the money for it, then they serving you the ish. And that just used to bother me, it hurt me to the bone. How could you be cool with killing little kids to feed your own? But then I got older, I realized that I was wrong. Cause people gon' get money any way that it come, Your Honor.
He served a sentence on y'all.
Can I do an acapella for you real quick?
Go ahead.
Alright, I got two acapellas and then I'll, you know what I'm saying?
Go ahead.
You ready?
Go ahead.
I'm from that 440 county, where even my day ones will doubt me. You fake to stay from around me. I know some real ones who dodge in the county. I know some real ones who dodge in the feds, yeah. Money on their head like a bounty. Those are the ones I keep close to me, case a white boy feel like getting rowdy. Back in my city now, don't need no pity now. Yeah. And then, you know what I'm saying? That's one of them.
Right.
The other one is, a cop said freeze and exercise your right to stay silent. Fine, but exercise your right to stay non-violent. Sad when sleeping people see your murders through their eyelids. Don't lie about what you did. You turn it violet. It's crazy the fear run through me when I hear approaching sirens. Y'all talk about the murder race, but y'all the ones behind them. But no one knows because you just write some BS, then you file it. But really, you putting more people in the sky than a pilot, Your Honor. That's it.
Man, that boy is killing him right there. Honestly, if y'all didn't know before he came, 440 Prodigy, yeah, that's a name y'all need to be thinking about because he just laced y'all up right here in the booth. I'm feeling like Flex or one of them dudes right now, Breakfast Club. Seriously, man, because when this video get posted up, a lot of y'all guys, they be asking me to interview y'all and rap. You better look at his stuff first. because he just killed it right here. And I appreciate y'all coming up here doing that, man.
You want to hear a little sneak peek of a hook real quick?
Yes. I want to hear everything that you got to offer, man. This is your time to shine for the world. All
right, man. Look. She said if you love... Oh, wait. I can't do it on the beat, though.
Go.
She said if you love something, then love it to the fullest. She said love is war, then shorty, come and take the bullets.
Hey.
I'ma take the bullets, shorty, no vest. Open up my shirt, shorty, show chest, yeah. She said if you love something, then love it to the fullest.
Yeah.
She said love is war, then shorty, come and take the bullets.
Okay.
If love is like a battlefield, well... Welcome to the battlefield, love. I'ma be there through the storm, sorry, all the pain. I'ma be there through the good times and all the rain. I'ma be there through the good, the bad, everything. From the day I put a baby in you to the wedding day. Switch them off to my soul. I link up with my bro. Way too many shots to my dome. Might forget the stuff that I roll, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I could dig that, man. I can.
That's coming soon.
You know what? All those motivations, man. Putting that good stuff out there. I was listening to, I think, like, for me, one of the things that I was doing was listening to what you were saying. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and not because, like, I think what it is, like, most black people, the first thing they think, I don't care how many white rappers come in this world. Yeah. As soon as a white person decide that they want to rap, that's when you getting the biggest ears that you can. People just need to glue them football ears on because they're going to listen to everything you say. They're going to see if you got rhythm, if you got flow, all of that.
I appreciate
and,
you.
And, yeah, man, you was holding that line down. And,
I came in late on the beat, but I hope I saved it, you know what I'm saying?
I didn't even catch that, be honest with you, man. Seriously.
I did.
Yeah, so, you know, you should feel good about yourself. I was in here watching this on the camera and stuff to see, make sure I was looking good and everything. And I noticed that y'all shining, man. Y'all looking good, you know what I'm saying? You got your own little style going. And is that a Beulah thing or is that just your own unique?
No, well, like, being fly is a Beulah thing. But, like, I like my own style. I like peacocking, man. I like wearing colorful things. I like wearing things most people wouldn't wear.
He said peacocking. You know cockadoodles.
Like, imagine, think about elementary school. Think about elementary school when you used to throw the parachute up in the air.
Right.
Look at this jacket.
Right.
Come on now. Nostalgic.
They gonna notice that, boy.
Look at the hat. Look at the hat right now.
Yeah.
Gerald. Hey, Arnold. Got his jersey number on the back.
He said nostalgic. And he said, Beulah, it is a fly town.
Shoes, like, the shoes speak for themselves.
Yeah, the shoes speak for themselves. That was the first thing. I went down and up like,
yeah,
man, this dude done pieced together a selection, man. He brought cross colors back in the building.
And it's fly, and
this 4-4 prodigy thing, it ain't a joke. He did just come up here and slay that track, man. And when you coming up with that, because, like, some of these people that come up here and I do interviews, they don't write all their music. So do you write your music? You got a ghostwriter?
All my music.
Okay.
I would never have a ghostwriter. I actually, like, when I signed with him, I said, can you promise me that I won't have a ghostwriter? Because I write my own stuff in my head, like, so, and I like my stuff.
Are they personal songs to you? Everything that you write, is it something that's like something that you actually went through?
So, like, a lot of them are, yeah. And then some of them is just wavy stuff. I just thought it sounded good, and I put it on there. And then the verses are fire. So, you know what I mean? So,
it was like, that was it.
Sometimes I just get in there, just have a good time, and I just make a song, like, just to make a song. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think you always have to have a full purpose to make a song.
Right.
Make a song. I mean, if it sounds good, don't go out there and, like, just freestyle it. If it sounds absolutely horrible, be like, yeah, you know what, put it out. I don't like that.
Right.
But, like, if it sounds fire, why not keep it?
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
And you know what? That's, I think, a lot of artists' processes. How do you function? How do you look at that? Like, when your artist is making some music, how is your decision making in the process? Like, how hands-on are you with your artists and what they developing, when you developing your artists?
I give my artists freedom, to be honest. They can write what they want to write. We don't have anybody that writes, you know, for them at all. And I'm not even thinking about that at all, because each person is different and each person's mind functions differently.
Right.
So everybody, you know, you want your own originality to your music. So
yeah.
Don't take that freedom of, you know, having somebody else write for you. You're going to write for yourself, be original,
yes,
and be unique.
Absolutely.
I feel like anybody, like, not anybody, but if you have a decent voice, I feel like you could just take a song and make that song. Like, and that, like, that's not that cool. You didn't put that much effort into that song. You didn't make
right.
that song. You just made that song sound good. You know
yes.
I mean?
Well, that was the thing about some of the,
lyrics that I heard that you had chose to reflect on in your music. Yes, sir. You were talking about like some things that you had witnessed in Ashton Bueller, like some tragedies people had went through around you, and like the type of struggle. Because a lot of people don't think, like out here in Ohio, like outside of Kirtland and Willoughby Hills, there's people that do have to sell drugs to make some money.
My mom is older than me, like double the age older than me, and I bury more of my friends than my mom has.
Right.
And that's crazy, you know what I'm saying? And like so many people we went to high school with, even recently, like just lost a buddy, Reggie. I've known him since I was in second grade, elementary school type stuff, you know what I'm saying? So it's tough. I lost my stepmom, but I lost my stepmom to like cancer, but she was really she was really bad into drugs, like her whole life for real. And it's big in my family, man. Drugs are big in my family. And, right.
But I didn't hear you, like you up here waving, and you know a lot of people that's waving, they on some drugs, you know what I mean? They rolling, they doing this and that. You weren't like promoting doing drugs. Like you're not out here like, yeah, no, I want everybody to pop a molly and stuff. You just talking reflectively.
Nah, you don't need to do drugs to have a good time. You can have a good time.
Right. Cause I don't drink or nothing, but I know there was a time where I had friends that did everything. And it was fun to be around them.
Yeah.
But then they started dying, and it's like, hey, man, I think you might want to think about some of this stuff first.
Yeah.
But using music as a platform to talk about that, like, do you try to be an advocate against, like, drugs and violence and stuff, or do you try to, like...
I think, for me personally, yeah, I'm very against, like hard drugs, like meth, heroin, cocaine, right? I'm very against pills.
Yeah.
Even if you're messing with pills, like, if you don't know this,
right,
okay... Just because you're popping a perk every now and again,
school us.
It doesn't mean that you're not a drug addict. You know what I'm saying? It's right. The same thing.
Drugs are drugs.
Because then it's no longer a want. You know what I'm saying? It becomes a need, and that's trash. Why you need that? What you need that for?
Right.
Look, I smoke a little bud on occasion. Sorry.
But it's legal here, though.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, but other than that.
He ain't messing around.
I'm good. I'm cool. Yeah.
Good to know, man. We got some good positivity up here going. Ty, what about you? How do you feel about your artists presenting like certain music that could promote violence and drugs and use and stuff like that? Is that freedom that you still, you pretty unobjective to that?
As far as that, I don't really sign any artists that do rap about, you know, doing other things. Because I don't want that persona and what people see and hear for them to think that reflects on us. So I try to steer away from that. But when it comes to anything else, like we're really truly strong about like bullying, putting drugs down, things like that. That's another movement I'm working on, is put the drugs down. But that's a whole nother situation that I gotta build up.
Right, absolutely.
But I'm making moves and trying to make moves of awareness.
Yes.
You know, my wife lost her mother recently. You know, and it's
sorry
crazy.
To hear
I lost
that.
I lost my brother recently as well too. He was killed by someone giving him some fentanyl and letting him sit there and die, you know. It was crazy. They didn't call the ambulance, nothing, just let him sit there, and then, you know, 20 minutes later called because they didn't want him there. He was making money, he was successful, and you know, a powerful black man, successful, and the people was jealous. It was working for him because he had his own business as well. Ended up killing him so they could try to take over, but it'll never be taken over.
He said never.
No, he's a legacy, and he'll stay a legacy. There's one reason why I grind for my brother, because, you know, growing up, we had our karaoke machine, you know, and our little tape recorder, and that's how we made music.
Right.
You know, and we did it together. And I just talked to a medium. I don't know if you guys believe in those or not, but I talked to one, and I asked about my brother. You know, I asked questions at first that they wouldn't know.
Right.
And they were able to tell me those facts.
Yeah.
So it was kind of like eye-opening, you know. I'm like, oh, okay, so tell me more. And they're like, oh, well, he's saying, you know, you do music, right? I was like, yeah. He was like, he's saying to keep going, but he's always going to be a better singer than you, LOL. You know, so he made them little jokes. He made his kids, this lady was telling me, and so she, you know,
what?
She said he wants you to keep going. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep going and keep going and keep going and help others keep going, you know?
Right. Man, you weren't scared.
Fart.
I would have been scared as
heck. I believe in it, and it's to the fullest. It's, one lady told me and my wife, because we were having a hard time conceiving, told me and my wife when we would actually be conceived and when we would get a positive.
And
we just got
a
positive. Yeah, we just found out just now we're pregnant, right when she told us we were going to find out too.
Congratulations,
man. Thank you.
And good luck on that endeavor and all of these. It seemed like you got a lot of baby missions, but it's all under one umbrella. Like you got to focus and you got a goal. And and a plan, man. And that's one thing that I feel is important, because you are relentless, man. You was, yes. You was texting and messaging, and it wasn't like, you know, overwhelming, but it just let me know that you were serious.
Yeah, of course.
Because, you know,
you
people
stay serious.
Yeah, they, that's what I was just about to say, man. A lot of people, it's not even that they procrastinate. I just don't think that they believe in themselves.
Right.
And then on the other half of that, you got people who, like, you got some people that are afraid of failure.
Exactly.
But you also have a flip side to that, where people are afraid of success.
Yes.
And if you're afraid to be successful, you know what I mean, that's going to cause you more pain than this is than to be afraid to fail.
To fail, yeah.
Because those failures turn into lessons. Like you said, you have family members that you had to lose. Fofo Prodigy said he also lost some things, took some losses. Like, we all take losses in the game. So this is one thing. I'm working on advocacy for toxic stress prevention. I don't know if you guys ever heard of ACEs. But it basically, like, gauges the level of stress that you had as a child and how that affects you later on in development. And one of the things that I think is important is finding out, like, how do people become resilient? Because there really isn't a cure for toxic stress. One of the main things that helps out with that is resilience. And I use music therapy to help me. So what are some things, Ty, and then 4-4 Prodigy, what are some things that you guys use, or some defenses that you use to keep you resilient during hard times?
I use music. I write. I mean, so I blew up in Ashtabula, right? And I was huge. I'm talking about people was coming up for pictures, autographs, you know, was scared to come up and even talk to me. And then this one girl started a whole bunch of crap, and people hated me, turned on me, made me hate myself.
One person.
Yeah, I killed myself, actually, and I got brought back a couple years ago.
You lucky.
And at that time I was like, man, why did you bring me back? All I remember is seeing the angels pulling me. You know, I seen what I wanted to go.
Yeah.
And it was something that was holding on that wouldn't let me leave. And I was like, man,
couldn't.
Just let me go. But they was like, no, you have a reason, you have purpose. So now I gave up music at that time too, because people were putting me down about it, so I gave up music. And I struggle a lot now still with depression and suicidal thoughts, things like that.
Man,
a couple
who
weeks
doesn't?
Ago, you
right.
know, I tried to jump off a bridge, but at the end of the day,
yeah,
I got to keep going. I got people by my side that's gonna stop me. Now I'm gonna say one thing. Like, okay, so my boy's right here, and his girl actually, like, years ago, she stopped me a while ago a couple of times from killing myself because she
this
was
my
there
queen.
For me. You know,
okay.
she was at one point my best friend, you know, who I could turn to talk to about anything, and that kept me alive. You know what I mean?
Right.
So with people, different people by my side to keep me alive.
Support.
You know, that's what keeps me going. That's what keeps me sane now, is the support, and that I know I have support, as well as writing music. It takes me away from the world.
Yes. Hey, you know what, man? You just answered that. I mean, there ain't no right or wrong with this.
Mine's not as personal.
Yeah, go ahead. I'm gonna comment on that.
I like listening to music, and I'm not gonna lie, like, when I used to get super stressed out or something like that, I would color.
Okay.
I had coloring books and stuff.
I do too. I had
and I would color. Now I got this coloring book app on my phone. And it's solid.
Color by number.
Hey, he's serious about the color. He really likes some colors.
Well, like, when you just got nothing to do.
Right.
It's nothing. They already picked the colors for you. I just got to tap it.
That's it. Easy
it's
money.
It's like, it's soothing. I don't
Easy
know.
Money. Man, you know what? Ty had talked on, touched so on a couple of topics. You used a few choice words that I usually don't hear record labels discussing. And that's another thing that I'm advocating for is, you know, the different type of mental things that we go through as adults. You know what I'm saying? You mentioned suicide, you mentioned depression, you mentioned anxiety, and, you know, that's not really like a cool topic. You understand?
Exactly.
Like,
it's
that's not something I ain't gonna walk up to my homies like, yeah, I'm gonna kill myself yesterday.
At the same time, though, it's cool to know, like, and people should know, like, everybody goes through that.
Man.
Every single person on this planet
they're gonna
has
have
been super depressed at some point.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, all of us go through it.
Yes.
And it's life. That's life. You know what I'm saying? You just gotta keep pushing. Just keep swimming.
But
just
that's
keep
the,
swimming.
That's the thing. Yeah. The keep swimming part, the keep pushing part. That's what a lot of people don't know how to do. Like, if you ever watch, I watched Maury Povich, or I don't know who the thing is now, Jerry Springer, whatever.
All of them.
Yeah. They got people on there 60 years old crying because they don't know who their father is or this and that. Like, man, you think people's like stuff that happened when they was 3 years old, they still remember that stuff minute for minute, and they holding on to it.
Facts.
And like, for each of us, because I got an amazing story too. But everybody that's up here, you know, we done went through some tragedies and different things to get to where we at. So I guess now my question is, and it's gonna be my final question, is moving forward, you know what I mean, how are you gonna use your music to touch America, touch the world, and help make a change with, you know, these stressful things that we go through? Like, how can you guys use your platforms to help us out?
Take my glasses off for this one. I just stay real. I just stay real in my music. Like, just stay real with everything that you do. You know what I'm saying?
That's it.
No one can knock you if you're you.
Right.
Right.
Originality.
Splada da. You don't even know what that means, but I said it.
Yeah, what does that mean?
Nothing.
Oh.
I was out at Coney Island one night, and my buddy out there that I work with was like, hey, splada da. And I was like, what? And he was like, you should put that in a, he was like, you should put that in a song. So when the song came on, I was like, hey, you know what it is? Fang Gang Entertainment, 440 Prodigy, splada da. All that, you know what I'm saying?
They so know just, what?
Just be weird.
And
be
it sounded weird. Saucy.
And it's that line from Alice in Wonderland, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's cool to be, it's all right to be weird. You know what I'm saying? All the best people are.
Yes, I was a loner.
We're all a little mad here. You
know I was a loner, and I was, I can't say I was antisocial, but I definitely was in a world of my own. What about you, Ty?
I stay alone. I stay to my family. So a lot of people bring drama and unnecessary things that will weigh you down more. And especially like when people started putting me down, like I'm talking about, it was so bad to the point that the cops were even putting me down, weren't helping me when I was
Dang.
Asking for help.
So like, so you know about this bullying stuff firsthand.
Yeah,
personal so issue.
It's crazy. So like, I'm working on a song right now, and with my songs that I do as an artist myself, I do songs that other people can relate to.
Yeah, on the real level.
I take my experiences, but I convert them to where we all have those experiences. So like I say in my one song coming up, they talk about I'm screaming out for help, but no one can seem to hear me.
Yeah.
I'm trying to stand tall, but society takes it all.
Yeah.
You know, so different things like that, people can, you know, Fire. Can relate. Society's gonna take everything and try to drain you.
Right.
But you gotta stay tall, you know, you gotta keep going.
Yes, they get,
so,
yes.
You know.
As got me thinking, I'm up here like, man, this man preaching. I feel like I'm at church right now.
Right, amen.
Yeah.
But, I mean, there's so many different things with the label that, you know, we're a family. We stay behind you. We want you to know that we're here no matter what for
right.
you. No matter what situation. If you're having a hard time, you need food on your table, talk to me.
Right. Not
you
know just a mean? Place that's, you're
exactly.
not just a distant.
It's just about the music. Yeah,
yeah it's not
about
just
everything.
About the music. It's about the relationship
exactly.
and building. That's what's up.
He messaged me like every day, too. Like every day.
Said he so, on it.
Yeah. I mean, I have an artist as well in Georgia that's doing an R&B, you know. And he comes from a different type of place. But some of these artists that I have from Georgia that are hitting me up, they're fire. Like, man.
They're going
like,
in.
Yeah.
Best unsigned hypes
yeah,
ever.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, and their stuff, I don't know why or where or what they're drinking down south, but they
coming
take a
up
beat
with that
and
talent.
They just kill it. Yeah. So, I mean, I have a couple of those people on, like, September 21st coming up, actually.
Yeah. Let us know about what events you got coming up and all your social media platforms, both of you guys. Yeah.
So, September 21st, we have a talent search. It's the first
yeah,
one
gonna be
of
lit.
Many where it's going to be in Elyria, Ohio. And it's at one of our recording studios, Great Sound Lab, Great Lab Sounds. And it's for everybody to come. If you're arts, if you have talent, if you're a singer, you're a drummer, you play instruments, whatever, you rap, you trap, whatever you do, you know, your talents as far as the music industry, come down, you know, audition, sit there, and we'll be able to help you. We'll be able to, you know, if you're scared to get out there,
right.
If you don't know how to get out there, we're here to help you, you know. We're going to sign a couple people down there as well.
He said he ready. So
yeah,
come
I'm
down
ready,
there.
I'm
Where is that going
to
be at again?
It's going to be in Elyria, Ohio.
Elyria, Ohio. Y'all so look out for that. And it's going to be at what studio again?
I'm going to pull up all the info right now.
Yeah, pull up the info, man. And while you do that, 44 Prodigy, you go ahead and let us know where we can catch you at on your social media profiles.
All right, you can catch me on Twitter as 440 Prodigy. But, like, if you type in my username, just 44 Prodigy, because they didn't let me do the heart. On SoundCloud right now, it's Young Prodigy. I'm trying to get that fixed.
How you spell it?
I think it's Young. Like
Y-O-U-N-G?
Yeah, yep. And then Prodigy. But it's 440 Prodigy. I just... When I first, like, when I was starting rapping, that was my name. And this is my name on SoundCloud.
It.
And then Snapchat, you know what I'm saying? Hit me up on Snapchat.
Hit him up on that snapper. Good old snapper dap.
But yeah, it's Drake Jackson 40. You know what I mean? Facebook, of course. I got an account for Drake Jackson. I also got one for 440 Prodigy. We also have a label page for me for 440 Prodigy as well. So yeah.
So he paged up, y'all. I hope y'all caught all that information right there. That was 440 Prodigy. That's how you get in touch with him. Back to Ion Records CEO Ty.
So it's Ion Records Music Talent Search. It's Saturday, September 21st, from 12 to 4. Pre-registration, if you do and don't want to wait in line, you come around 11 o'clock, we'll be there. Or you can email ionrecords.llc@gmail.com. that's ionrecords.llc@gmail.com. And the address for that is 505 Half Broad Street, Elyria, Ohio.
Y'all gotta come too, cause I'm never up at 11,
right?
Ever.
He said he never
I mean, it's completely different though. We're in the mix of working a whole tour coming up. I have a couple spots, you know, selected already. A couple people talked to, called all about the music.
And we've been talking. We've been to put something together. What they don't know, they're gonna be so salty.
Exactly.
We gonna have it looking like not the Freaknik, but when on how what was it? How high? When they had went and gave dude them brownies.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. He was up in a function. His wife was like, "Man, what's wrong with you?" Like, "I'm hungry, then a motherfucker." So they eat all the brownies. They was up in there jamming, man. We trying to turn. I want to turn because Lake County really doesn't have. Isn't known for being a party spot. People get robbed and shot out here. You know, it's got a tougher reputation in Cleveland. Some areas. So I want to get the college population together that's local, and we have one big event that's hosted. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? And it's all about peace, and we have, you know, certain themes, you know, like the no bullying issue. I think that's a real good deal. The toxic stress issue, I think that's a good deal. Suicide, you know, drugs, heroin, all of these different things that we need to address to help our community out. And I feel like music is my lane, so I'm gonna stick to that. And that's how I ended up connecting with you. And man, you made it happen. So
I want to do one big show though next year in the summertime. We got to get it down. I got a guy that does foam, so I want to get a big foam music festival party, whatever, going. I performed with this foam last year, man, and it was fun. I'm talking about there was foam flying everywhere, people dancing through the foam, coming out, you know.
So we can have a foam party?
We can have a foam party. We can light up an adult foam party with music of all genres.
I don't like foam. But I would have a foam party though.
Yeah,
you would love it. Trust me, you would love it, man.
I do it.
I think we need to try that out, y'all. So y'all let us know what y'all think. Thank y'all for tuning in. This is Lakeland Lake Effect Radio Station.
Splatter that.
Thank you, 440 Prodigy, Ion Records, Ty Johnson. It's been real. Yes, sir. So we finna end this interview, man. But I think that you guys brought a definitely magnetic feel to the studio. Y'all came with them good vibes. You know what I mean? You weren't faking or portraying who you were. You just was you. And that's one thing that we love on this show, man, is just the originality. And, you know, you guys took a hold of that opportunity, that power, and that motivation, man. That's what it's all about. Thank you, my viewers, and all the online listeners to Lakeland Lake Effect Radio Show. Y'all have a blessed night.
Appreciate you having us out here, too.
Yes, sir. Yes, indeed.
Thank you.